anything else. So nervous, though, for these guys at the moment.
Long time since we saw an Estonian on the podium. Not so long since we saw a Russian on the podium. It was where? It was in Portugal earlier on in the year.
When you were commenting on Novakov's third co-driver, as many events, when he got that podium with Denis Yurede, is he going to get another finish? They say this is the expectation. It's down to the finish of this stage. Denny on the full mission to try and get some time back. But this helps.
I'll
tell you what, it's a good job he turned left, because he went much further past the tree. He would have properly crunched that. A few seconds lost there anyway.
Then the end of the third stage of the loop, and this one, a small little mistake near the end of here.
Yeah, it was a bit slippery and just missed the braking, so I didn't want to take a risk and to put the car sideways, so just went straight a bit, so nothing special. Just keep going, that's all.
He's a very calm young man indeed. This is another calm man, maybe not quite so young as Mikko Hirvonen, just going about things as we would expect him to do this morning. Julian, doing a really, really good job out there. No real dramas for him in the morning's loop of stages.
Well, we hear it time and time again from drivers when they say you don't want to push because you don't want to make a mistake, and you've got to find the rhythm, and it's really, really difficult.
Nico, well, the morning's over and done with. All's going still to plan, so you're happy with that?
Yeah, it's been all okay. No problems, really, and everything has been working perfectly, so good morning for us.
No, we didn't start today. It was an interesting spectator out there.
Sebastian, it's still a crash, aren't we? But it's only two wheels instead of four. What's going on today?
I broke two wheels, so I have only two left. Oh, what's going on? I just go to see the rally with friends, and that's it.
Is it with the disappointment of yesterday, this is better to do this than come in the rally car?
Yes, maybe. So, yeah. It's not often that I can watch those are driving, so I took the opportunity.
Well, after stage 11 then, Hirvonen's lead has increased, but it's tighter in the battle for second. The M-Sport boys within 50 seconds of each other following that mistake by Novakov. Osberg remains on course to catch both Atkinson and Ogier if he can maintain the same pace. Well, into the afternoon's stages. Julian, a repeat of this morning's stages. And here we go. Who's first up for us this afternoon?
Mads Osberg is first up. Obviously, the man on that charge from seventh to fourth. And he did do it, he proved me wrong, and he did it quite easily, if we're totally honest with you. I was just a bit shocked when he said it this morning, and really thought, again, look at the crowds.
Joseph, the problem really wasn't with Mads Osberg, it wasn't with the difference, it was with your arithmetic.
Yeah, that's never a great thing for me.
Mads, this morning when you were here, you said you're on target for fourth place. I questioned that, because I thought you were further back, but exactly. Looking at the split, you are going to be up into fourth at the end of this one.
Yeah, okay. We understood quite early on that we were going a bit quicker than we thought was necessary today, but it's no point slowing down when we are enjoying it. So, okay, we didn't take the risk we take this morning now, so I backed off a little bit a few places just because the stones were quite bad. So, but still, we are pushing hard and really enjoying it, so it's good fun.
Roy Tanak, Julian, in third place at the start of the day. That was always his plan for the day, to stay in third. He did have a little nibble at Evgeny Novikov in the first stage of the morning, but then it was all about just keeping the pace, keeping it steady, keeping the car in the middle of the road and holding on to that third place.
That's it. We make it sound so simple from here, but look at the ruts, look at the rocks. It is just the most difficult thing.
Some monster rocks out there this afternoon.
Yeah, there were some, I don't know whether they're exaggerated, but they were saying there were some really massive rocks, particularly in stage. I mean, the first one of the loop, wasn't it? Every driver commented on it.
As big as a television, I'm told.
How big's your telly?
Pretty big.
That's okay then.
Well, Roy Tanak did a great job out there, and as you say, Julian, just look how cut up the surface became out there. It was still a real test today. We didn't see the drama of yesterday, but it was still a real test.
Right, day three, Saturday in Sardinia. It's over and done with, still in third place. It's probably been the longest day of your career.
Yeah, for sure, and we are going like really, really, and almost like road mode, and really careful at some places. Okay, for sure. I'm sure that if it would have been just a usual place or just a place to fight for something at the moment. We would have been much quicker, but at the moment all the rocks and a bit like cobblestone places feel so rough that you are so careful, like driving a group N car. But okay, we are happy, we are at the end of the day, and at the moment everything is going like planned.
Well, you can tell he's excited, Julian. That was probably three times as long as his end of day interviews usually are. But this is the man that Tanak was chasing, I suppose, for a small part of the day. Really, it was all about holding position for Tanak and this man, Evgeny Novikov.
Well, that's it. You look at a helicopter shot here. But yeah, Tanak had to basically give himself a bit of a target. And we know that Evgeny spent most of the day kind of looking at the computer screen, checking Tanak wasn't getting him. So these two M Sport cars, the two youngsters, basically it was like shadow boxing, wasn't it, all day with each other. You know what surprised me about Sardinia this year, Colin, compared to maybe 3 or 4 years ago, the narrow, really twisty roads have disappeared. It's all nice, fast flowing, so stuff still rough, but really nice and fast and flowing.
Some new stages this year. Here we go.
Evgeny, all day today, you've probably been watching the splits more than you've been watching the road, just making sure you're keeping ahead of Tanak. It's been another strong day.
Yes, everything was on the plan, everything was fine. Just trying to keep our place, that's all. Everything goes well. It's all fine.
Second place going into tomorrow, two stages to go. What's the plan for those two? Power stage points or not?
No, of course, no. Just the same plan as today, just to keep our position at the moment.
Yeah, power stage, what power stage for these two youngsters. They are purely looking at the podium, Julian. This man, though, well, you wouldn't bet against him in the power stage tomorrow, but again, he's driven so well. What more can we say about the way that he just, you know, whenever the team ask him to do a job, he just picks it up and he goes with it without any dramas.
That's why you sign this man. He is the most reliable driver, Bastian Loeb, in the championship. And Citroën have both of them. When one falters, the other just picks straight up. He did it in Portugal. He was taken away from him for technicality, but he did the job.
He did the job in Portugal, and let's hope that he can go on and do the job tomorrow here in Sardinia. So narrow, Julian, you're talking about the stages being wide and fast and flowing. There are still sections like this, clearly.
Yeah, but when we were here in like 04 and 05, they were really, really big. Those big rocks that you see were really close to the roads. The fans, and even more seem to be out this afternoon than this morning.
Problems in that corner for Hirvonen. Really no problems at all today for Mikko Hirvonen.
Mikko, Saturday in Portugal was very similar to Saturday in Sardinia, apart from it wasn't raining. Rallying days like this are quite boring, but you'll take those days.
Well, we have to, you know, there's every stage has to be finished, and okay, we don't need to fight so much, but really need to be concentrated all the time to avoid mistakes. And again, we managed to do that, so it's looking good. Two more stages to go, so not too bad.
And two short stages that. What's the plan for the power stage?
Well, I don't really need any points before the championship, and I came here just to try to win the rally, and that's the goal. So there's no rush tomorrow either.
Here's our leaderboard then at the end of day three. No change at the top. Hirvonen still leads with Novikov in second and Tanak in third. Østberg is the big mover of the day in fourth. And the battle to watch tomorrow is between Atkinson in fifth and Ogier in sixth. Well, just two stages to come on the final day here in Sardinia. The roughest, toughest stages of the year have given us more drama than Shakespeare. The curtain's down for today then. Join us tomorrow for the final act.